passwords suck for a bunch of reasons.
It is the bane of people's existence on computers today.
So passwords fundamentally just don't work with how people behave and how they really go about their lives.
They're supposed to be secure, and they're amazingly insecure.
We need to get rid of passwords. That's not blue sky. So I knew Jim Clark since Stanford days. I was a grad student and he was teaching classes, so he will not remember me at Stanford because I was one of many students, but I remember him. And you know, I wanted to know what the world had to offer and get to understand things. So I went to an IDC conference in late 1994. So I actually pinged him after and said, "Hey Jim, you may or may not remember me, but I was one of your students. Why do you talk about cryptography? Your presentation had a lot of errors in it." So he invited me to his office. The company was called Mosaic Communications at the time. And we chatted, and I ended up consulting a little bit to the company, changed name to Netscape, and ended up joining as chief scientist in early 95. And then the company says, "You know, by the way, we're going to put transactions on the internet." And we're looking at each other and say, "How on earth are we going to do that?" So we ended up, you know, building the SSL protocol as a solution to that problem. And the problem is the internet was so open. SSL survived until now. It got modified a few times to answer security issues. And we forgot one thing. We didn't forget it. We just didn't pay a whole lot of attention to who the consumer actually is. So we had an option in the SSL protocol for the Amazon's, for the server side, for the shopping cart, to ask the consumer who they are. And that resulted in the password dilemma that we have today in the internet. So this is actually the number one security issue in the digital world today, by far. And if you look, any threats, any breaches, anything that happened in the entire world in terms of security issues, they're all is an interesting thing. 99% of them were because of a password problem. But at the time, we just did not picture what the world would look like in year 2020. We could not. We also did not picture attacks that were developed later on. We did not know that social networking was gonna be a thing. None of that stuff existed. There were no mobile phones, by the way, when this thing was done. We did not claim that solution was going to solve every single security problem that would come later on, because we did not know what these are. But we focused on solving the most important security issue. When you're actually conducting a transaction, you want to make sure this is the right amount, the right person, the right entity, the right account number, and basically conduct a transaction, and that's what we focused on. The system was already designed to understand and use certificates. And, you know, certificates are used for authentication in the SSL protocol, but certificates can also be used to sign things. And signatures, which is actually the nature of what a certificate is, are longer term, perhaps longer term things. So the idea of self-assigning a set of keys for each user to choose a bunch of keys and build their own certificate so I can sign things and send them to you is actually novel. We've always built certificate based on somebody, a trusted third party, issuing certificates to all of us. Because I can do a certificate for myself and claim to be Bank of America and show it to you. How do you know I'm Bank of America or not? So the trusted third party was actually very important in terms of authenticating the entity, the server side. We thought we had to do that with the client side, and you know, the nature of this new idea is that we actually don't. Is that the only thing you need to do is to register the key with the back end that you care about. And then when you continuously use the same key, you know that this is the same entity. So the idea of the self-signed certificate on the user side, so that the user gets to decide which devices they own, and they control their own keys and their own identities and their own data, is kind of awesome. Now we're in a privacy-driven world now. There's so many privacy things. So anything that is user-driven is going to be looked at very favorably. So the fact that we can enable each user to have be their own certificate authority in the language we use and issue their own keys, register the keys they want with whoever they want to register with. You've done the initial step, and then you can prove yourself ongoing by just showing the key, not showing the key itself, but showing the effect of the key, which SSL does, actually. Like Albert Einstein used to say, when you arrived at the simplest way to solve a problem, you know you got something.